tonight's game, it promises to be a good one between the South Carolina Gamecocks and the Florida Gators. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our Star Watch for today's game. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Check out the small forwards. I think these kids are great to watch. These guys deserve to be in the starting lineup because of what they bring to the table.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go. And after all the anticipation, we're underway. Moving it around the perimeter. Number zero picks up the foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, he's just a freshman, but hey, we all got to start somewhere.
Well, he's out there seeing a lot of this for the first time. It's going to be important that he gets the right direction and guidance from his teammates and coaching staff.
Makes his first. Number four set to record his first action.
Hey, this guy will give you a great hustle on the defensive end of the floor.
Free throws go. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
And we'll get a change of possession. He may be in some trouble here.
There he is. Strips the ball loose.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. He gets the bucket.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
They look to get it to the inside. Goes up for two. That was nice.
That was absolutely phenomenal. Nice low post play. Good entry to the box.
And score it. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. In the lane. They get it to go. On the outside. Launches the three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
For two, he can't get the hoop to fall. Trying to feed the low block. Turnaround jumper. Can't connect. Allen receives the ball. They go into the low block. He attempts the jump shot. Scores it. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He attempts the trifecta. Missed it. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from the corner. Nope. They work the perimeter. with the J.
I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
I'm sorry, Brad, but this young fella seems to be their only hope at the moment. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He can't let this guy have an uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He puts up the J. Nails the J. They work it around the perimeter. Three. Missed the jumper. Didn't look like anything was going to keep him from the basket there, Dick.
That's a great take, Brad. That puts pressure on the defense when you go to the hoop like that.
He uses the shot fake. He goes up with it. Off the mark. Blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Inside.
And the fans love it. Just with joy, fans. Hey, that's my guys yelling.
Out on the right wing. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, the two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man. Gotta think right now, gotta focus defensively.
On the wing.
Trying to go inside.
Puts it on the floor and up and under. Off the mark. Tries for two. Hard foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, that's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
When he gets to the line, he's usually making them.
Mentally, he truly believes that he can knock it down. It's a trait that many good free throw shooters have.
And he got them both. They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
Great trap, Brad.
On the left side. Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. The missed shot. On the dribble, gives it up. He unloads a three. Perfectly executed. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
On the right side. Great hustle. Out on the wing. Now trying to feed the low block. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Jumper won't go. Side. He shoots from the deep corner. Can't connect. And it's knocked loose.
isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Jumper and come up short. They work it around the perimeter. Pass out of bounds for the turnover.
Well, you credit that to two factors. One, great team defense, but number two, lack of communication offensively, not in rhythm and sync.
Into their zone motion now. The Gators are becoming regulars at the national tournament.
It's the story of evolution. Evolution of a college basketball program.
Gave it up for two. Makes the shot. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside.
He gets the foul, and the layup will count, Dick.
Hey, way to play strong, my man. Way to play strong.
Well, here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
The shooting guard receives the ball.
There's the screen up on top.
He shoots the jumper. They got it. Great strength on that drive.
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's the basket, sometimes you get fouled.
Number 21, he got the layup to go and the foul is called.
Hey, he saw that he was going to get fouled, but he stuck to the path in spite of it.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, Brad, you look at your juniors as third-year players who have been there. Nothing should be new to them by the time they're in their third season. They should know what's expected from them in the classroom, and they should know what to expect from their conference opponents. The level of familiarity should be much higher than what it was in their first year.
Goes up.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Could they be confused on defense right now, Dick?
That's just a lazy effort, Brad.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. He wants a three. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Working it around the perimeter. Jumper nails the J. Number 24 takes the pass.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
The crowd starting to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
On the dribble, gives it up, takes his jumper. And score it. We're at the 6 minute mark. They move it into the front court. For the bucket. You betcha. Takes it strong to the hoop.
He knows how to use his strength, Brad. That's such an important skill. You've got to know how to use it without being called for the foul.
Dumps it in. Goes up with it.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Oh, Looking for a good shot. Takes the jumper. Nails the jumper.
Look at that spacing.
Too physical. The layup counts and the foul.
He went hard to the hoop knowing he was going to get fouled.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. Now, Brad, as a coach, your seniors are a very important part of their operation. The underclassmen look up to them and really lean on them for guidance and direction. When a senior accepts this role and leads by example, it helps the coaching staff and the team immensely.
About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock.
Great shot block right there. And some good movement on the offensive side.
Now working around the arc. He pulls up with a jumper. Nope. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the block shot.
Turnover committed by the freshman. He tries the jumper. The missed shot. Robinson receives the pass. Missed the jumper. Gave it up. About 4 minutes remaining. Number four receives the ball on the outside. Tries for two. Can't connect. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
Kicks it out. He attempts the jump shot.
Inside.
Goes up for two. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He puts up the J. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
On the left side.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
For two, goes. The 2 minute mark. Robinson handles the feed, knocks it down. Got it down to the low block. He goes up with it. Jumper won't go. With the jumper. Off the mark. The point guard gets the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Blocked! Nice job defensively. Missed it. The small forward takes the pass. Fed the low block. Puts up the J. Off the mark. Tries for two. He gets the bucket to fall. Trying to pack it inside. Goes up for two. It sticks. Silva handles the pass. Trying to feed inside. He shoots the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Pull-up jumper from way out. Scorches the net with a J. At halftime, the Gamecocks are ahead by five. Florida is not having the best of days on the boards in the first half.
Hey, subpar rebound and performance by this squad so far. Seems like everybody's waiting for someone else to grab the rock.
Checks back into the ballgame.
Yeah, I knew they couldn't leave him out for too long.
Going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. Gave it up. Listen to the crowd. You can cut the intensity with a knife.
They just have to focus, Brad. That's most important, mental toughness.
Down inside. From the corner, perfectly executed. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Gators talked about hitting the offensive glass during halftime. This was a point of emphasis, which they basically ignored in the first half. Look for them to start sending four or five players to the boards with hopes of getting an offensive putback. It may be a risky play at this point, but they must make a move. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. The small forward takes the pass. From the corner, nails a sweet jumper. They look to get it to the inside. He fires it up. In and out. Missed shot. Moving it around the perimeter. The student section is all rallied up and they are ready to battle.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
On the dribble, gives it up. He pulls up with a jumper and come up short. Gave it up. Jumper. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
Goes up with a shot. Nope. A little two-man action. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Trying to feed the low block. Here's the big man with a drop step.
Oh, he does a phenomenal job getting post position, good angle, and then the drop step.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. They got it. On the dribble, gives it up. Puts up the jumper. Knocks it down. Gave it up. From the corner, he misses the jumper. For two, off the glass and no good. On the outside for the bucket, off the glass and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the jumper, busts the J. Go into the low block. He tries the three ball. Missed the jumper. The Gators prefer a more balanced attack. They play up tempo at times and then really settling in the half court at other times.
They feel they are more successful when they focus their attention on doing a bit of both, Brad. They have the personnel to be able to play up tempo at one end and play the half court at the other.
Inside. He attempts a jump shot.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, it might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
Way out on top. Control of the ball. It's good.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from the deep corner and score it. With the J, off the mark. There's a slam. Great strength on that drive.
Great job of using the bounce to get to the rim. Not too many defenses that can stop that move. Turnover committed by the senior.
Here they go in transition. From way outside. Nails a sweet jumper. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
Way out on top, controlling the ball, tries for two, off the glass and no good. He puts up the J, nails the jumper.
trying to go inside.
The Gators did a great job in the offseason recruiting. They have a few talented freshmen in this lineup.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Takes his jumper off the mark. Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how the dribbler uses the screen is important in a pick-and-roll situation.
Tipped in.
What a great tip. What a great second effort.
8 minutes left in the game clock. They work the perimeter.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
The missed shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. What a pass on the backdoor cut.
Terrific pass. That's great timing. Caught the defense sleeping. A great backdoor pass.
Now trying to feed the low block. Goes up for two. Sinks it. Seven minutes left on the game clock. Inside for two. Scorches the net. For the bucket. They got it. Gave it up. Baseline jumper. They get it to go. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up with it. Knocked it down. About 6 minutes remaining on the game clock. Tries for two. Off the, and the block. And now there's a whistle and a foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the line for the first time. First shot, good.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBN.
They're working around the perimeter. He puts up the J. Missed the jumper. On the left wing for the deuce. Rims out. He shoots from the top of the key. Busts the jumper. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right time.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Step to the line for the free throw. Wide, short, long, doesn't matter, doesn't go. second one, no good. And Dick, they just can't seem to find the touch from the line tonight.
Well, no time for lessons, Brad. They gotta start knocking them down before it's too late, baby. High post screen, gonna use it.
Goes up for two, off the glass. On the dribble, gives it up. Number zero, subpar performance is just destroying his confidence.
Someone may have to talk to him. He needs to get back on track.
He couldn't get it to fall. Ball's gonna stay down here. The Gators have been getting it done with a number of players here, Dick.
When you have guys that want to win, you're gonna get different players stepping up in different ways. When it's about the W, individual numbers aren't important.
Out of the air. Takes the jumper. He misses the jumper. He hits the shot. 4 minutes left on the game clock. On the right side. He attempts the three. He misses the J. On the left side. Looking for a good shot. Look at that student body. They are going mad.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Gave it up. Up with the shot. And yet another missed field goal attempt, Dick.
Wow, when a team is shooting a ball like this, I'm telling you, they're not focused. They're going to drive the coach bananas. Practice is going to be so tough tomorrow. I mean, they need repetition, repetition, repetition. And it's nothing but one brick after another.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. With the J. Miss after miss after miss. Dick, their shooting has been horrid.
Wow, I'm speechless, Brad, and you know that never happens. I don't know what to say. They couldn't be shooting the ball any worse.
Dumps it in. The turn, a fadeaway jumper. He misses the jumper. They work it around the perimeter. Puts up the J. He drains the jumper. About 2 minutes remaining. Dumps it in. He pulls up with a jumper and come up short. Allen handles the pass. He gets that one to fall. And a momentary look from three-point land. He goes up with it. Off the glass and no good. Working it around the perimeter. Jumper! He misses the J. Was that beautiful or what? I think that's why college basketball has the following it does, Dick. People from all over town and throughout the campus come and enjoy themselves at these games.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
Looking for a good shot. He launches a three. A severe offensive drought for them right now, Dick.
And it doesn't seem to be turning around as of yet, Brad. That's basic.
Well, now it's just a matter matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? Let's take another look at this dunk.
Hey, now that's taking it strong to the hoop. Look at him throw it down.
On the inbounds play. Shot clock is dead. And the clock stopped with a foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Baseline inbounds. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. The offense sets up from the sideline. And the clock stopped with a foul. They'll throw it in from the side. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Buries it.
They need a basket here to turn this into a two-possession game.
Timeout on the floor, folks. More ESPN coverage coming up right after this. Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
With limited time remaining, it's very important that the players have a clear understanding of what the coach wants them to do when they return to the floor. They'll have to be on the same page, or else it could cost them the game.
Okay, then it's time to put the game plan in action, Dick.
Hey, it certainly is, Brad. Whenever you get the chance to get a quick break and regroup, you need to be able to come back onto the floor ready to carry out your game plan. Whether it's a defensive or offensive focus, you've had the chance to talk about it. Now's the time to do it, to execute.
Timeout, we're all set to pick things up. They'll work it around the arc. The Gamecocks now running a zone offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Number 24 to the charity stripe. Good. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Sinks it. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. He puts it up at the horn with a layup. Florida was caught in quite a battle tonight before pulling ahead for good.
They'll be happy to walk away with a victory from such an evenly matched opponent.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.